A St. Louis trauma surgeon wants the countless people with bullets in their bodies to consider coming to him to have those bullets removed. Fox Files investigator Chris Hayes shows you the groundbreaking effort to change the way we treat shooting victims.
When you see news of shootings on TV, it's rare to see faces of those struck, like the six people shot this past weekend in St. Louis, last known to have survived. They may also be sent home from hospitals with bullets still in their bodies, like Annette Smith, who was shot in 2021.
I was in my bed watching TV, and I was shot in my back, 3:30 in the afternoon.
Here she is being treated by medics inside her home that day, while a relative watched on FaceTime, praying for Smith's survival.
They told me that if I didn't have that headboard and the pillow behind my back, that I would have been dead.
Smith walked around with that bullet in her back for 2 years.
It was in a spot that it was hard to remove, and it just started giving me so much pain, and it was starting to get infected, so I found a doctor that would remove it.
Dr. LJ Punch with the Bullet Related Injury Clinic, also known as BRIC.
Most people survive bullet injuries.
Dr. Punch says most survivors are told it's too dangerous to remove a bullet.
There is a lack of research, practice, and a lack of knowledge about what to do about bullets that are left in people's bodies. We use pre-Civil War medicine to guide our practices because a mantra came about, or a dogma in surgery, that taking bullets out, dissecting wounds, going down and pulling out the missile was more harmful than not, at a time when surgical technique didn't have the most basic practices to prevent infection and promote healing.
Dr. Punch is trying to change how doctors respond.
There's this public ongoing outcry, right, about reducing gun violence. Why is there not more attention to addressing its immediate impact when someone's actually shot? That is why I built the BRIC.
He says he's treated 800 patients since 2020, many who he believes were mistakenly told it was safer to leave the bullet in their body.
For many people, walking around with a half-inch piece of metal that was intended for their harm, that experience is devastating.
For Smith, removing that bullet from her back was part of her feeling safe again.
I wouldn't go in that room for maybe 4 months. I closed the door. I would not go in the room at all. I was just traumatized.
She does feel safer and less stressed without that bullet in her body, but she still struggles with the fact her shooting remains unsolved and wonders if that lack of accountability could lead to someone else being shot by the same person. For the Fox Files, I'm Chris Hayes.